Hi friends. In today's video, we're going to show you how to make your image come alive using BannerBoo. To split our image into different layers, we'll be using the free Photopea editor. So, let's get started by duplicating our image onto the next layer. Just hit the Ctrl plus J keys on your keyboard. Then, press Ctrl plus U to open up the Hue Saturation menu for further tweaks. Alright, now we can play with saturation, brightness, and hue of any color we want. So, we need to make sure the area we're selecting becomes super dark. This trick will make our image selection process a whole lot faster. Let's take red as an example, since we can find it in both the earthly objects and the sky. We can see how its brightness changes in sync. Alright, our focus is on selecting the land, the dog, and the woman. So, let's dim down the brightness of that vibrant red color. We'll do similar tweaks with the other colors too. The goal is to create a super high contrast image, while still keeping those tiny details intact. Now select the object selection tool. Right-click on the image and choose color range from the menu. The area we want to select is highlighted in white. We can use the shader to adjust the depth, but 40% should do the trick for now. Click on OK, and there you have it, our selection is now dotted. To catch those missed areas in our selection, let's zoom in on the image by scrolling and holding down the Alt button. Then, navigate around the image by holding down the Space button. Use the Lasso Select tool to add any unselected areas. When you press the Alt button, our tool will remove areas from the selection. When you press the Shift key, it will add to the selection. So, hold down Shift and draw around the desired area. As you can see, it's now added to our selection. Continue these manipulations until we have the entire area we need selected. Super! Now that we have the entire area selected, let's go back to the previous layer. Once the layer is selected, press Ctrl plus G to create a new layer with just our selection. Oops! It looks like a small part of the sky got included in our selection. We can easily fix that by using the lasso tool to select it and then press the delete key. Now, let's press Ctrl plus D to cancel our selection. It's time to separate the other parts of our composition. To do this, we'll use a more precise tool called the pen selection tool. First, let's zoom in on our image. Then, click to place the first point of our selection. While holding down the mouse button, create additional points to adjust the curvature of our outline. Repeat this process to complete the selection of the remaining parts. To finish the selection, combine our contour by clicking on the first point. Now click on our contour with the right mouse button and choose Make Selection. In this way, we create an area selection. In the same way, we go to our main layer and press Ctrl plus J. As we can see on this layer, there is still land with part of our heroes. So, we choose Lasso Select again and draw around the part that we need to remove. The more useful space we leave, the better. But make sure that the space between the objects that we want to keep and those that we want to remove is remain. Once you've made your selection, simply press Shift plus F5. In the drop-down window, choose the Content Aware option and click OK. Give it a moment while the editor replaces the selected area. If you're using Photoshop, you'll find that this function works even better and will save you some time. As you can see, the background has been changed. But the result isn't perfect due to limited information for the tool to work with. In this situation, we can use the brush tool by pressing the B button and paint over most of the area with a similar color. Now let's use the patch tool. Select the area you want to replace, then drag it to the spot with the texture you want to copy. The tool will automatically select the colors and transitions for you. We also remove all irregularities from the contours using the lasso tool. In this case, we're happy with the result because it nicely covers the majority of the area in front of the previous layer. Now let's focus on animating parts of our image, specifically the clouds. We'll use the pen tool to select a part of the cloud that we want to animate. If you want to see what's underneath your outline, you can make it transparent by clicking on Fill in the top panel and removing the background. Now, let's select our main image by right-click and choosing Make Selection. Once the selection is made, press Ctrl plus J. Next, click on the Move tool located above and drag our cloud particle to the center of the workspace. To flip the cloud horizontally, go to File, Transform, Scale, right-click on our selection, and choose Flip Horizontally. Align the cloud to roughly match the second part, press Enter, and select the Eraser tool. Set the opacity to around 23% to make the eraser's work less intense. Right-click anywhere on the working area to access the menu. From there, we can reduce the hardness of the eraser tool by approximately 25%. Now, we can start erasing the rough edges of our cloud section. Great job! Let's select both of our cloud layers by holding Ctrl and then press Ctrl plus G to group them together. Right-click on the group and choose the option Convert to Smart Object. Excellent! Our cloud is now ready. Now let's create the sun. Select the ellipse tool and draw a large circle. To ensure it's perfectly round, hold down the Shift key while drawing. Now let's add some color to it. Click on the fill option and choose a gradient. You can adjust the colors of the gradient by double-clicking on the color control, which will open a palette. Alternatively, you can simply pick a color from our image. To export each layer, it's recommended to convert them into smart objects. This way, when you double-click on the object, it will open in a new window. You won't have to manually resize or crop it. The working area will automatically adjust to fit the object. To export our artwork, we can follow these steps. Click on File and select Export. Choose the desired format, such as PNG. Adjust the size and quality settings according to your preference. Click Save to download the file to your device. Repeat the same process for all other layers that you want to export. Great! Now that we have uploaded our files to BannerBoo, let's add them to our workspace and bring them to life with animation. Make sure to position the images with a slight margin outside our working area. It will be essential for creating engaging animations later on. Instead of the background, we will use a gradient. To do this, go to Vector Images, Gradients and drag any gradient to our workspace. Select it, change the color and degree of the gradient. Now move it to the background and adjust the color. Don't forget to add the clouds as well, but position them to the right of our working area since that's where their final animation position will be. Now, let's adjust the duration of our layers to the desired length, which in this example is 10 seconds. We set the layer with the cloud for about half the time and extend the in animation to the maximum. On other objects, pull in and out to the middle. To set the animation, click on the in or out of our animation. Select Custom and set the left parameter. Make sure to increase this parameter with each subsequent layer. Set the easing parameter to ease and out. Ensure that the in and out animations of the selected layer match each other. In the next layer, we'll make the animation larger, but with a negative sign. We will make a layer with our sun with the top parameter to simulate its sunrise and sunset. For the cloud, we set only an animation. In the custom animation, set the negative parameter left as our cloud will move from left to right. We set the easing parameter to linear. Now we move our cloud down the timeline. To ensure smooth playback, we can increase the size of our animation. Great! Now let's duplicate the cloud and move it further along the timeline. We can also adjust its position to be slightly higher and change its size. Now let's preview our composition. You can further enhance your design by adding more layers, experimenting with different animation parameters, and exploring the effects library in BannerBoo. On the screen, you can see some examples of animations with different parameters. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Have a nice day and see you in the next videos.